We are asked to simplify the given cube roots. We know we have cube roots because the index is 3. A cube root will simplify if the radicand contains any perfect cube factors. To help us identify perfect cube factors, we often look at the prime factorization of the radicand. So for number 1, we begin by determining the prime factorization of 54. 54 is equal to 6 times 9, 6 equals 2 times 3, 9 equals 3 times 3. Which means the cube root of 54 equals the cube root of 2 times 3 times 3 times 3. Each time we have 3 equal factors, we have a perfect cube factor. So notice here, 3 times 3 times 3 is a perfect cube factor of 54, and therefore this does simplify. To emphasize this, let's write this as the cube root of 3 cubed times 2. Again, 3 cubed is a perfect cube factor of 54, and we'll simplify. If you want to, we can also write this as the cube root of 3 cubed times the cube root of 2. The cube root of 3 cubed simplifies perfectly to 3, and therefore this simplifies to 3 times the cube root of 2. After doing this a while, though, we'll typically go from this step here to the simplified radical. Number 2, we have the cube root of negative 32. Let's ignore the negative for a moment and look at the prime factorization of positive 32. 32 is equal to 4 times 8. 4 equals 2 times 2. 8 equals 4 times 2. 4 equals 2 times 2. 32 is equal to 5 factors of 2. But we have negative 32, and we're looking for perfect cube factors. Well, negative 1 raised to an odd power is still negative 1. So let's write this as the cube root of, for the negative, let's write negative 1 raised to the third, and then we have 5 factors of 2. Let's circle the perfect cube factors. Negative 1 raised to the third power is a perfect cube, and so is 2 times 2 times 2. To emphasize this, let's write this as the cube root of negative 1 to the third times 2 to the third times 2 times 2. Negative 1 raised to the third power is a perfect cube, and so is 2 to the third. The cube root of negative 1 to the third simplifies to 1 factor of negative 1. The cube root of 2 to the third simplifies to 1 factor of 2. And the cube root of 2 times 2 does not simplify, so we still have times the cube root of 4. This is equal to negative 2 times the cube root of 4. Now let's look at our last example. 108 is equal to 2 times 54, and therefore the prime factorization of 108 is going to be 2 factors of 2 and 3 factors of 3. So let's write this as the cube root 2 times 2 times 3 times 3 times 3. Now we have 7 factors of x, and we're looking for perfect cubes. So we could write out 7 factors of x, but instead, let's write x to the 7th as x to the 2nd times x to the 2nd times x to the 2nd. Here's a perfect cube factor of x to the 7th, but we still have one more factor of x. And then y to the 3rd is 3 factors of y. So now we'll circle groups of 3 equal factors, which are the perfect cube factors of the radicand. We have 3 factors of 3 here, we have 3 factors of x squared here, and we have 3 factors of y here. When simplifying, each group of 3 equal factors will simplify to 1 factor. So for this example, let's go straight to the simplified radical. The cube root of 3 times 3 times 3 is 1 factor of 3. The cube root of x to the second times x to the second times x to the second is 1 factor of x to the second, and the cube root of y times y times y is 1 factor of y, and we're left with whatever is not circled under the radical, so we have the cube root of 2 times 2 times x, which is 4x. This is the simplified form of the given cube root. I hope you found this helpful.